Hi, I'm Frank Wright from publicspace.net. Today I'm going to show you how you can rename your photos using the metadata that your camera embeds in your image files at the moment when you shoot your photo. I'm going to start by launching my About a Finder Rename batch renaming program. Then I'm dropping some demo files into the preview. So you can see that we've got a whole bunch of photos here. There are 17 pictures from my new Sony A7 Mark IV, a picture from my iPhone camera, and finally, a few holiday snaps from a few years ago, taken with my old Sony A6300. Now, the very first thing that you want to do when you use metadata to rename your photos is to have a look at what is actually in your files, because different cameras write different information into the image files. So let's look into what information we have on this file. Down here in the info pane, where About a Finder Rename shows you everything it knows about the file. It knows the location on the disk and the creation and modification dates. It's important to realize that those are file system creation and modification dates. That means those are not embedded in the photo, but they are just the dates and times that the files are first copied to a computer. Usually, they don't mean an awful lot. This file, for instance, was created on the 12th of December on the file system, but it was actually shot on the 9th of August, 2019, in a completely different year. So this shot-on date is the first thing that we really get from the embedded metadata. Note that the images are currently not sorted correctly. These files here were shot in 2019, but they're at the bottom. And this much more recent file is at the top of our list. As you can see, we are currently in the sequence numbers category and have selected the produce sequence number list action. The reason that the photos are not in chronological order is because we are sorting by name and sequence number. If we change this to sort by EXIF digital camera date, they will be sorted by this shot-on field, and my holiday shots from 2019 get sorted correctly in front of the new photos, and my recent iPhone photo all the way at the end. Another way of exploiting this particular field is, of course, by renaming to dates. The format that is most useful for most files is the 4-digit year, month and day, and the 24-hour time, because this will usually give us unique file names that also sort correctly alphabetically. And we simply switch over to the digital EXIF date, and we're done. Now, the real power of renaming with metadata comes from the tags category, because here we can access all the information that is in the file. So here at the moment, we have this particular format, which is image width times image height. The red numbers here are produced by About a Finder rename, because at the moment, all these files would end up with the exact same name. You probably already know that every file in a folder needs to have a unique name, so About a Finder renames file conflict resolution feature adds some distinguishing characters to the end. You can configure exactly how it does this in the preferences. So we delete this pattern and we use something different, like for instance, we go to the shutter count. Let me put that in here. This brings up this warning dialog here that says that the shutter count field is not available for all of our files. So only the files that actually have a shutter count will be renamed. You can see that for my new camera, each one of those pictures has its own unique shutter count. The shutter count corresponds to how many photos have ever been taken on this camera. So this is only the 67th picture that was ever taken with my new camera. Then you see that the iPhone doesn't have that information. Neither did my old Sony camera. So those just don't get renamed at all. And that's why there's also conflict here. So let's have a look at what else About a Finder Rename knows about our photos. So we can see that there's no caption, no keywords, and no user comment. Those are typically things that you add in your image management software when you organize your photos. Once you have created them, you can use them here to include them in your file names. We also have the image width, and you can see that we have the image width, we have the EXIF image width, and we have the source image width. These can have different values based on how your camera processes the photos. So over here we have 6048 pixels. This is a raw image file. And when the camera actually processes the data, it gets rid of the 24 pixels around the borders. And that is how we end up with only 6000 pixels. But this is of course not the only thing here. We have the color mode, which is standard. And then there are some additional fields that you might want to set in your image management program, such as the city, the country, the province, the state, etc. There's no GPS data for this particular image because the camera doesn't have a GPS module. Here you can see that different cameras provide different metadata. So here we have different image dimensions. We have different color mode information, but nothing else now. The camera here gives us other information as well, like the aperture, the shutter speeds, exposure time, the ISO, the make of the camera, the model. Then some cameras have got serial number information in this field, but my Sony does not. Now we get to the information about the lens. So this is taken with the f/50mm 1.2 G Master lens. Then you get information about which focal length was used. So here we have 50mm. Because this is a full-frame camera, that's the same as the 35mm equivalent. But if you look, for instance, at a picture from my Apple iPhone 14 Pro Max, the focal length is 2.22mm, which corresponds to a full-frame focal length of 48mm. There's also some color space information. Sometimes you do have shutter counts. As an example of what we can do, I can add the image dimensions at the end of the file name. You can put any combination of text and tags in this pattern field to create your own file name convention. You can also, if you wish, use the individual date components here to build your own date format. For instance, let's assemble a 4-digit year, 0-padded month, day, hour, minute, and second format. Note that for some cameras, you can also use the subsecond value in milliseconds. So you can see that the subsecond is available for the pictures taken by my new camera, but not for my iPhone pictures or those taken with my older Sony camera. Another convention that we might want to use is, for instance, the information about the camera plus, let's say, the lens. We can also just copy this and add it to the beginning of the file name. Or we can put it at the end of the file name. Or we can do a million different things with this data. I hope you found this to be useful. Please subscribe for more content, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks for watching.